بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والى وبعد. الحمد لله إخوان, the month is finally upon us, and it is indeed from the ni'mah of Allah Azza wa Jalla that He has allowed us to reach the month of Ramadan. شهر مبارك, as the Prophet ﷺ described it, a month that is mubarak, يعني a month of barakah, a month of blessing, a month of khair, a month of rahmah, a month of fadl from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah Azza wa Jal to give us and grant us tawfiq in utilizing our time well during this month. It may be our last Ramadan. Ikhwan, from that which we've heard in tonight's recitation, the beginnings of Surah Al-Baqarah, Allah Azza wa Jal makes mention of that which is related to the believers, and the fact that the believers, they truly are the ones who are benefited by this Quran. And this month, Ikhwan, is the month of the Quran. The month of Ramadan, as Ahlul Ilm mentioned, is Shahrul Quran, as they refer to it likewise as Shahrul Sabr, the month of patience. But it is the month of the Quran, Ikhwan. And if it is, as is the case with most of us, that we have been negligent and had shortcomings in relation to the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then Ikhwan, let this shahr, let this month of Ramadan be the month that we return back to the book of Allah Azza wa Jal, and that we're diligent with the book of Allah in reciting it, in reading it, in understanding it, in reflecting upon it. For indeed, brothers and sisters, there is no book like it. إِنَّ هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ يَهْدِي لِلَّتِي هِيَ أَقْوَمُ وَيُبَشِّرَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ الَّذِينَ يَعْمَلُونَ الصَّالِحَاتِ أَنَّ لَهُمْ أَجْرًا كَبِيرًا. Allah mentions, indeed this Quran, it guides to that which is better, and it gives glad tidings to those who work righteous deeds, that they will have a great reward. The book, brothers and sisters, that if a person concentrates upon it, memorizing it, studying it, spending a portion of his day with it, then no doubt he becomes from the people of Allah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he mentioned to a gathering of his companions, "Inna lillahi ahlin min al-nas." On an occasion, he said to them that indeed Allah Azza wa Jal has people, yani chosen people, from mankind. And so the companions, Ridwanullah alayhim, they said, "Man hum ya Rasulullah?" Who are they, O Messenger of Allah? Of course, anyone who hears that statement from the one that was sent by Allah Azza wa Jal would be eager to know who these specific people of Allah Azza wa Jal are. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he responded by saying, "Ahlullah." Oh, hum ahlul Quran. Hum ahlul Quran. Ahlullahi wa khasatuhu. He said that they indeed are the people of the Quran. They are the people of Allah and His specific chosen ones. And so the book of Allah Azza wa Jal, from its characteristics as it relates to the one who reads, studies, acts upon it, is that it causes him to be from Ahlullah, from the people of Allah. And what a mighty and tremendous characteristic for a person to have, that he is from the people of Allah. And Imam Al-Ajurri rahimahullah ta'ala, he mentions the fact that when a person becomes from the people of Allah, then there are some characteristics that manifest upon him. That carrier of the book of Allah, whether he has memorized it in completion, or he has memorized the majority of it, or he has memorized half of it, or he has memorized as much as he has been able with concentration upon it and reading and studying it, then they have characteristics. And he mentions in his beautiful book, The book Ikhwan, that no individual from the Huffaz of the book of Allah Azza wa Jal should be without studying akhlaqu hamalat al-Qur'an, the characteristics of the carriers of the Qur'an. He mentions, Ikhwan, and we mentioned briefly some of the characteristics that he mentions about Ahlullah, the carriers of the Qur'an, the carriers of the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He mentions, rahimahullahu ta'ala, فَأَوَّلُ مَا يَنْبَغِي لَهُ أَنْ يَسْتَعْمِلْ تَقْوَى اللَّهِ فِي السِّرِّ وَالْعَلَانِيَةِ بِاسْتِعْمَالِ الْوَرَعِ فِي مَطْعَمِهِ وَمَشْرَبِهِ وَمَلْبَسِهِ وَمَسْكَنِهِ. He said the first thing that is befitting upon the carrier of the Qur'an and the one who manifests the akhlaq of the Qur'an, the first thing that is befitting for him to manifest and to act upon is the fear of Allah Azza wa Jal, in private and in public. As far as the fear of Allah, Ikhwan, in public is concerned, then mashallah, most of us have mastered that. But the fear of Allah Azza wa Jal in private, the real fear of Allah Azza wa Jal, then where are we? Yeah, we may be good, Ikhwan, at looking like muttaqi, looking like a person of taqwa. But how are we in relation to true taqwa? And that is fisir wal alaniya, in private and in public. How are we when we're alone? Or how are we when we're with our specific companions, the ones that we're able to relax with? How are we? So the first characteristic, the fear of Allah Azza wa Jal in public and in private. He mentions بِاسْتِعْمَالَ الْوَرَعَ, and that is by way of him having piety in his mat'am, in his food, وَمَشْرَبِهِ, and his drink, وَمَلْبَسِهِ, and his clothing, وَمَسْكَنِهِ, and his living dwellings. He said بَصِيرًا بِزَمَانِهِ وَفَسَادِ أَهْلِهِ, that he is aware and acquainted with his time, yani the time that he lives in. He's cognizant of the time that he lives in and the corruption or the corrupt nature of some of those who live around him. He said, فَهُوَ يُحَذِّرُهُمْ عَنْ دِينِهِ عَلَىٰ دِينِهِ, that so he warns and he instructs based upon his religion. He said مُقْبِلًا عَلَىٰ شَأْنِهِ, that he is one that is diligent in seeking his goals. مَهْمُومًا بِإِصْلَاحِ مَا فَسَدَ مِنْ أَمْرِهِ, concerned with rectifying what has become corrupt from his affair, yani his own inner corruption, that which he himself knows of, that he rectifies it and he's concerned with that. حَافِظًا لِلِسَانِهِ, guards his tongue. مُمَيِّزًا لِكَلَامِهِ, that he defined, he is definite and clear with his speech. إِن تَكَلَّمْ تَكَلَّمَ بِعِلْمٍ, if he speaks, he speaks with knowledge. إِذَا رَأَى لِلْكَلَامِ صَوَابًا, if he sees that his speech is correct. He said وَإِن سَكَتَ سَكَتَ بِعِلْمٍ, and if he remains silent, he remains silent with knowledge. And how, subhanallah, we have differed from these characteristics. Subhanallah, Ikhwan. Now, when we speak with jahl, ignorance, believing that we know. And when we remain quiet and silent, we remain quiet and silent out of fear and out of cowardice. How different we have become. He mentions إِذَا كَانَ السُّكُوتَ صَوَابًا, if being quiet is what is most correct. He said قَلِيلَ الْخَوْضِ فِي مَا لَا يَعْنِي, he is little and he rarely enters into what does not concern him. He mentions يَخَافُ مِنْ لِسَانِهِ أَشَدُّ مَا يَخَافُ عَدُوَّهُ, he fears from his tongue the way he fears from the worst of his enemies. قَلِيلَ الضَّحِكِ مِمَّا يَضْحَكْ مِنْهُ النَّاسِ لِسُوءِ عَاقِبَةِ الضَّحِكِ. He is little in laughing about what most of the people will laugh about because of the evil outcome of that laughter. بَاسِطُ الْوَجْهِ. He has a pleasant face, pleasant countenance. طيب الكلام. His speech is good. He has nice, good speech. لا يغتاب أحد. He doesn't backbite any individual. And that is, of course, as far as the haram backbiting or the backbiting that is defined by the Sharia. ذكرك أخاك بما يكره. You mentioning about your brother what he does not like. And ذكرك أخاك بما يكره includes that which is literal speech and that which is typed, ikhwan. Whether it is in those WhatsApp groups and rooms, over text message, email, it is still ghiba. It is still backbiting. That statement, would your brother like it if he were to hear it? Or if he were to learn of it? That statement, would it displease him if he knew about it? If so, then it is considered ghiba. And of course, we make a difference between speaking about the people of innovation or those who need to be warned against. That is different. Of course, that is a different scenario. We're speaking of that which is related to haram, ghiba in relation to the Sharia. He mentions, وَلَا يَحْقِرُ أَحَدْ. Neither does he ridicule or mock anyone. وَلَا يَسُبُّ أَحَدْ. Neither does he curse anyone. وَلَا يَشْتُمْ بِمُصِيبَةٍ. Neither does he curse because of a calamity. A trial or a difficulty, a hardship, calamity overcomes him, and so he begins to curse. The Messenger of Allah would not say except that which pleases Allah Azza wa Jal. He said, وَلَا يَبْغِي عَلَىٰ أَحَدٍ. He doesn't transgress against anyone. وَلَا يَحْسُدُ. Neither does he practice jealousy in relation to him. وَقَدْ جَعَلَ الْقُرْآنَ وَالسُّنَّةِ دَلِيلُهُ إِلَىٰ كُلِّ خُلُقٍ حَسَنٍ جَمِيلٍ. And he has made the book and the sunnah his evidence and his shining light in that which is related to every khuluq, every mannerism that is good and jameel, every beautiful mannerism. And that is from the characteristics, and he has mentioned much more, but ikhwan, will summarize on that note. Let us utilize this time now, ikhwan. Alhamdulillah, we have been prepared for its arrival. Allah has blessed us to reach it. Let us benefit from it, ikhwan. This is the first day of Ramadan. Let us start as we mean to go on. Utilize these days well. Plan our righteous deeds throughout this day. Use our time well, ikhwan. Use it well. It may well be our last. Wallahu ta'ala a'lam wa sallallahu wa sallam wa barak ala nabina Muhammad. Akhir da'wana anil hamdulillahi rabbil alameen.